Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsline and here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 21st of March. Political war erupts between BJP and Congress as opposition points to freezing of accounts. Attacks at Pakistan's Border Port Authority complex kills dozens. And Sri Lanka allows foreign research ships for replenishment after Chinese protest. And now for all the details. Political tussle has erupted between the ruling BJP party and main opposition Congress party as the Congress has accused Modi government of creating a situation where there is no level playing field for the opposition. Taking a veiled attack at the BJP party, Congress President Mallikarjun Kharge said party filled its accounts with thousands and crores of rupees and on the other hand, under a conspiracy, the bank account of the main opposition party has been frozen. Kharge said, as the Lok Sabha elections have been announced, it is essential for a democracy that polls are conducted in an impartial manner. Congress leader Rahul Gandhi lashed out at the centre and asserted that there is no democracy in India today, alleging that the idea that India is a democracy is a lie. He said by blocking the accounts of the largest opposition party, the BJP has caused great damage to Indian democracy.
All our bank accounts have been frozen. We can do no campaign work. We cannot support our workers. We cannot support our candidates. Our leaders cannot fly from one part of the country to the other. Forget fly. They can't take a railway train. And this has been done literally 2 months before the election campaign.
Meanwhile, hitting back at the Congress party over the freezing of the bank accounts, BJP spokesperson Sambit Patra said it was the utter desperation of defeat that the grand old party has created an alibi. He further said that the party has nothing to do with the action being taken by the Income Tax Department.
जहां तक बैंक अकाउंट फ्रीजिंग का सवाल है, यदि आप हिंदुस्तान के कानून के हिसाब से कोट अनकोट आप डिफॉल्टर हैं तो यू विल बी ट्रीटेड एज अ डिफॉल्टर. ये जो सेंस ऑफ एंटाइटलमेंट है गांधी परिवार की, हम डिफॉल्ट भी करेंगे और डिफॉल्ट करने के पश्चात हमें इस देश के कानून के प्रावधानों को पालन करने से राहत दिया जाएगा. The era of this kind of entitlement is over under Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Ye era nahi hai ab. Chahe aap Gandhi parivar ke hi kyun na ho sakte. Aur dusri baat jo main kehna chahta hoon, remember, it is not the bank account of the Congress party which is frozen. It is the Congress party which is frozen.
And Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi held separate telephonic conversations with Russian President Vladimir Putin and Ukraine's Volodymyr Zelensky, discussing efforts to strengthen ties with both, his office said in a statement. The Indian Prime Minister had dialed up Putin to congratulate him on his victory in Russia's weekend presidential election, and the two leaders also discussed Ukraine, the Kremlin said in a statement. The Indian side, in its own statement, said PM Modi reiterated India's consistent position in favor of dialogue as the way forward in the Ukraine crisis and that the leaders agreed to deepen bilateral ties. Later, PM Modi also spoke to Zelensky, strengthening ties between India and Ukraine and conveyed India's consistent support for all efforts for peace and bringing an early end to the ongoing conflict. New Delhi traditionally has close economic and defense ties with Moscow and has refrained from criticizing Russia over its February 2022 invasion of Ukraine. However, it has not refrained from expressing discomfort about the conflict with PM Modi, emphasizing that today's era is not the era of war, which also was echoed in New Delhi's G20 summit communique. A US diplomat urged Pakistan on Wednesday to investigate reported irregularities with last month's general election and rerun the vote in affected constituencies if it found credible evidence of interference. Assistant Secretary of State Department for South and Central Asian Affairs, Donald Liu, in a congressional hearing, said U.S. never used the term free and fair in characterization of February election, adding that concerns were also raised about the pre-election environment in the South Asian nation. We have expressed concern about the failure to register individuals, candidates and political parties, the mass arrests of those in opposition, the shutdown of internet and censorship and pressure placed on journalists, he added.
The day after the elections, the State Department issued a clear statement. We noted undue restrictions on the freedoms of expression, association and peaceful assembly. We condemn the electoral violence and restrictions on human rights and fundamental freedoms. We condemned attacks on media workers and restrictions on the access to the internet and telecom services. And we expressed concern about allegations of interference in the electoral process and stated that claims of interference and fraud should be fully investigated.
The February 8 election in Pakistan was marred by arrests and violence ahead of vote, an internet shutdown on election day, and unusually delayed results leading to accusations that the vote was rigged. Shehbaz Sharif became Prime Minister on March 4th, heading a coalition after his party won fewer seats than candidates backed by jailed former Prime Minister Imran Khan. Earlier this month, several U.S. lawmakers had also urged Biden administration to withhold the recognition of Sharif's government until a thorough, transparent and credible investigation of election interference has been conducted. Moving on, multiple blasts and gunfire at Pakistan's Gwadar Port Authority complex on Wednesday has resulted in the killing of 2 Pakistani soldiers and 8 terrorists. Pakistan's Inter-Services Public Relations informed in a statement that a group of 8 terrorists attempted to enter the Port Authority colony but was successfully thwarted by security forces personnel. The Majid Brigade of the proscribed Balochistan Liberation Army has claimed responsibility for the attack. The Majid Brigade is opposed to China's investments in the province of Balochistan and accuses China and Pakistan of exploiting the region's resources. The Gwadar port, which is controlled by China, is significant to the China-Pakistan economic corridor. It includes multi-billion dollar roads and energy projects and is also a part of Belt and Road Initiative. Responding to remarks by former military officials of United States, Taliban on Wednesday said Afghan soil will not be used to attack against any country. Former CENTCOM commander General Kenneth McKenzie, speaking at the congressional hearing, has said Taliban has given refuge to terror groups which are attempting to attack United States and its forces. Dismissing the claim, Taliban spokesperson Zabiullah Mujahid has said, Taliban has not given refuge to any terrorist group. Afghanistan does not allow its territory to be used as a threat against America or any other country, and there are no foreign groups present in Afghanistan that could be considered a threat, Mujahid was quoted as saying by Tolo News. Taliban, which has seized power in 2021 after the withdrawal of U.S. forces, has also been accused by its neighbor Pakistan of harboring terror groups, which Islamabad says conducts terror attacks in its territories. However, Taliban denies the accusation. Sri Lanka on Thursday said it will allow foreign offshore research ships for replenishments at its ports, despite a one-year ban on such vessels after China protested over Colombo allowing a German service ship but turning down a similar request it had made. This is the first time Sri Lanka has officially admitted foreign research vessels will be allowed for replenishments since President Ranil Wickremesinghe's government imposed a one-year ban on offshore research vessels last year after strong security concerns raised by India and the US following the visit of 2 Chinese high-tech research vessels in 14 months. Sri Lanka Foreign Minister said the ban on foreign ships is for research purposes, not on replenishment. In August 2022, Chinese Navy vessel Yuan Bang 5 docked at Hambantota in southern Sri Lanka for replenishment. This drew strong protests from India, citing security concerns in the Indian Ocean. Chittagong, the second largest city in Bangladesh, is facing a severe water crisis amid drastic increases in the salinity of its primary water source, the Karnaphuli River. Empty buckets, pitchers and containers were seen lining the city's streets on Tuesday near pumps where rationed water is provided intermittently. The salinity of the Karnaphuli River has increased as climate change-induced sea levels rises causes the intrusion of salt water upstream from the nearby Bay of Bengal, rendering the water untreatable and undrinkable. Saline water is undrinkable due to its high salt content, which can lead to dehydration and health issues.
Samisha, amra shaptar bitore ekbar pani khai othoba du shaptar bitore ekbar pani khai amra thaki gorib manush bosti gore ekhane mone koren kom takar bitore bara thaki ekhon pani jodi pani o na khai gas o nai lakri jalai onek koshto am go din jabon jay.
The crisis comes as the bustling port city, home to more than 8 million people, is bracing for the fast approaching sweltering heat of summer, and as much of its population is fasting from dawn to dusk during the Muslim holy month of Ramadan.
আর পানি তো যদি না আসে ধরেন না বিভিন্ন রকমের চলাফেরাতে কষ্ট হয়ে যায় গোসল করা খাওয়ার পানি মানে বাচ্চাদেরকে পয়বস্কার করে রাখা বাচ্চাদের মানে বিভিন্ন রকমের সমস্যা হয়ে যায় কারণ না গ্রুপ অনেক নোংরা পানিগুলো আমাদের থেকে ব্যবহার করতে হয় ডেফা আছে এখানে ডেফা তো এগুলো আমাদেরকে ব্যবহার করতে দেয় না এগুলো সরকারি আন্ডারে সরকারি লোক ছাড়া এগুলো ব্যবহার করতে দেয় না টুকটাক মানুষ যদি ব্যবহার করে অবৈধভাবে ব্যবহার করে
According to tonight's edition, we will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.